Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the common collector configuration of the BJT. So in case of this common collector configuration, this collector terminal is common between the input and the output side. That means here, the input is applied between the base and the collector terminal, and the output is measured between the emitter and the collector terminal. Now here, when we say that the collector is common between the input and the output side, then actually we are referring to the AC signal. But for the DC biasing perspective, the circuit would look like this. And here, to use this BJT as an amplifier, it is biased in such a way that this base emitter junction gets forward biased and the collector base junction gets reversed biased. And in fact, in terms of the DC biasing perspective, it looks quite similar to the common emitter configuration. But here, this resistor is connected on this emitter side. But when we talk about the AC signals or during the AC analysis, all the DC voltage sources are considered as zero. That means during the AC analysis, this collector terminal gets grounded. Now when we apply the AC signal at this base terminal and when we measure the output at this emitter terminal, then we can say that the input is applied between this base and the collector terminal and the output is measured between this emitter and the collector terminal. So this is how the AC input signal is applied at the base terminal and the output is measured at the emitter terminal. And if required, the load can be connected over here. But for simplicity, if we neglect this base resistor and the coupling capacitors, then the equivalent circuit for the AC signal would look like this. But for the DC perspective, this is how the biasing voltages are applied. So now, if we see the direction of the currents, then the direction of the currents in the circuit would look like this. So here, this base current is the current on the input side, while this emitter current is the current on the output side. And similarly, if we see the DC voltage on the input side, then it is equal to VCB and the DC voltage on the output side is equal to VCE. That means here, this IB and the VCB are the currents and voltage on the input side, while this IE and the VCE are the parameters of the output side. And similar to the other configurations, the behavior of the device can be described by the two characteristics. That means the input and the output characteristics. So first of all, let us see the output characteristics. So this output characteristics defines the relationship between this emitter current IE and the voltage VCE. And if you look this different IE versus VCE curves, then it is very similar to the common emitter configuration. Because over here, this emitter current IE can be given as alpha times IC. And as the value of alpha is very close to unity, so we can say that this emitter current is approximately equal to collector current. That means with the change in this voltage VCE, the variation in this emitter current is similar to the collector current. And that is why in this configuration, the output characteristics looks similar to the common emitter configuration. Now, if we talk about the input characteristics, then it shows the relationship between this base current IB and the voltage VCB. And as you can see, for the fixed value of voltage VCE, as we increase this voltage VCB, then this base current IB reduces. Because this voltage VCE can be given as voltage VCB plus voltage VB. That means for the fixed value of voltage VBE, as the voltage VCB increases, the width of the depletion region increases. And due to that, the effective base width reduces. And as the effective base width reduces, the probability of recombination in this base region reduces. And due to that, this base current IB reduces. That means as the voltage VCB increases, this base current IB reduces. Now for the fixed value of VCB, as we increase the voltage VCE, or in other words, as we increase this voltage VBE, then the base current IB will increase. Because as the voltage VBE increases, more and more electrons will be pushed by this emitter terminal. And due to that, this base current IB will increase. That means for the fixed value of voltage VCB, as we increase this voltage VCE, then the base current IB will increase. Or in other words, for the larger value of VCE, the entire curve will get shifted on the right hand side. Now, as I said earlier, in this common collector configuration, this emitter current is the current on the output side, while the base current is the current on the input side. And the ratio of this emitter current to the base current is known as the current gain of this common collector configuration. And it is denoted by the symbol of gamma. That means gamma is equal to IE divided by IB. And this gamma can also be represented in terms of the alpha and the beta. So now let us find out the relationship between this alpha, beta and the gamma. Now we know that this emitter current IE can be given as IC plus IB. That means this gamma is equal to IC plus IB divided by IB. And if we neglect the reverse saturation current, then this collector current IC can approximately given as beta times IB. That means gamma is equal to IC divided by IB plus 1. And that is equal to beta plus 1. That means gamma is equal to beta plus 1. Now we also know that this beta can be given as alpha divided by 1 minus alpha. That means beta plus 1 will be equal to alpha divided by 1 minus alpha plus 1. That is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus alpha. That means we can say that this gamma is equal to beta plus 1, that is equal to 1 over 1 minus alpha. So this is the relationship between this alpha, beta and the gamma. Now from this, we can say that gamma is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus alpha. And if we multiply both sides by the alpha, then we can say that alpha into gamma is equal to alpha divided by 1 minus alpha. And we know that alpha divided by 1 minus alpha is equal to beta. That means we can say that this alpha into gamma is equal to beta. So these are the relationship between this alpha, beta and the gamma. Now this common collector configuration provides the very high input impedance and very low output impedance. And that is why it is often used for the impedance matching in the amplifier circuit. Then if we talk about the current and the voltage gain, then it provides the very high current gain and very low voltage gain. So in this configuration, this current gain is equal to beta plus 1 and the voltage gain is close to unity. And if we talk about the power gain, then this configuration provides the low power gain. So these are the basic properties of this common collector configuration. And we will see in detail about all these properties during the AC analysis of the BJT. So I hope in this video, you understood the basics of this common collector configuration. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.